Alright, are you ready?
Yep.
Do you want to have kids?
Yeah.
What kind of world would you wish for them to grow up in?
Fran, do you want a whole list?
That we can sit down and watch Finding Dory together, and then we can go and swim in the Great Barrier Reef and see Nemo. Finding Dory? Finding Nemo.
I think I would like my kids always learning. So in a world that they're constantly being educated from different aspects of how they live and where they want to live.
What I want is a world where we've eliminated discrimination, particularly in the form of casual, everyday racism.
Well, I would imagine a future where that everything is accessible.
And Find Nemo. And that's just looking like a less and less possible future. I'm worried about these places still existing in my lifetime. What will this world look like for my children and for my children's children?
I want a world where the inherent nature of business is not simply just to make a profit, but also to do good and make an impact.
Aren't we getting along? What is it that...
Because no one is donated, that we think about ourselves so much, if you know what I mean. Whether it's thinking about a pizza.
Yeah.
I think I'd want kids that are well-travelled and well-educated and, like, find it easy to be on the move.
You know, sometimes I'm standing behind or in front of barbed wire fences with my auntie being like, oh, you know, so there's your so-and-so's dreaming and, you know, this is, you know, important to us for this area, and we have fences between us, so we have buildings on top of, you know, our stories and our culture. I won't be able to tell the same stories with the same landscape to my children, and that our culture will literally just build over, you know. I feel like they never stop trying to get rid of us. They'll just build over us until we don't exist anymore.
It's like dodging the people again. Because we never dodge. If I know what I mean.
Some people say we talk too much.
Some of us like me too. But I love people.
Finally, I think it's a world where particularly youth are engaged in the future of our society and developing the solutions to address our biggest issues and take and have the opportunities and the support to take those problems and create the solutions by themselves. They're not sitting around for someone to approve it. They actually, you know, they're empowered, they're engaged. They have the technical skills, the tools to go out there and create the change themselves. That's ideal.
Yeah?
Yeah.
All right.